State of Grace is a song that I wrote at the beginning process of making this album, and I think it helped to define what the rest of the record was about just with one line. There's a line in that song that says, "Love is a ruthless game unless you play it good and right." And that's kind of like a warning, you know, for the rest of the record. Like, this is what's going to happen if you don't play this right. And this is what could happen if you do. So it almost serves as the perfect kind of warning label for the rest of the record. As soon as you hear that song, you know it's like, there are two ways this could go. You could be good to people, or you could, you know, not play fair. And both the outcomes are reflected on the record. Red is a song that I wrote halfway through making this album, and it changed what this album became. Because this song is about correlating different emotions to different colors. And it hit me all of a sudden that most of the emotions I'd felt in this process of making this album were red emotions. All the intense ones at the happy and the angry, you know, end of the spectrum. And it really changed my outlook on where this record was going, because to me this song is very different, very descriptive, and it has an edge to it that to me kind of expanded what I wanted to do. Treacherous is a song that I wrote with Dan Wilson, and I brought in this idea because I wanted to explore the idea that something could be dangerous and enticing at the same time. You know, but the positive side of that, like, I believe this can work. You know, it's got this big bridge at the end of it that kind of sounds like a second chorus. It's got all these vocals in the background, and it says, "Nothing safe is worth the drive." And to me, that says so much about this album, because I really do feel that even if something really hurt you, if it made you feel something, it was worth it. I Knew You Were Trouble was an idea that I got almost 6 months before I was scheduled to write with Max Martin, and I emailed him and said, "I just got this idea. I can't wait to bring it to you. I know that we're not writing for a few months, but I need you to know I thought of this thing. I can't wait for you to hear it." And I have never written a song like that where it's like, it's not shame on you, you broke my heart. It's shame on me, you broke my heart. I saw the red flags from the first second. God, you feel so stupid. But it's got that chaotic sound in it. It's got that really bold edge to it where the song sounds like that feeling felt. The song All Too Well is a song that I wrote. It's the first song I wrote for this record, actually. And it kept coming back to me because it told a story so well in such a full way. It starts with meeting someone and all the details about that innocent beginning, and it follows the story all the way to the bitter end. And it's a really emotional song because it does show you why loss is so painful, because it was once good and you can remember it. The song 22 is kind of an idea I got while I was on a plane. And I ran into the studio with Max Martin and Johan Schellback, and I was like, "You guys, listen to this!" And and they loved it too, so we worked on it. And I wanted to write a song about what my summer had been like with my friends, with that kind of attitude of like, we are in our 20s and we don't know anything and it's awesome, you know? And it's kind of fun to embrace that. And I gotta say, that's probably one of the biggest choruses on the record. The song I Almost Do is a song I wrote about the conflict that you feel when you want to take someone back and you want to give it another try, but you know you can't. And you can't because it's hurt you so deeply that you know you couldn't bear to go through that again. And so you're sitting there and you're wondering where they are, and you hope they think about you, and you're almost picking up the phone to call them. But you can't. So it's an emotion that I think I needed to write the song in order to not call that person, actually. I think that writing the song was what I did instead of picking up the phone. We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together was a song that I wrote with Max Martin and Johan Schellback, and it happened really spontaneously while we were writing. This guy walked into the studio, and he was friends with my ex, and He made some comment about how we were probably going to get back together. He left. I went on a rant that sounded something like, and you know, the thing is, we are never, ever getting back together. Like, ever. I am never going through that again. That was, like, ever. We are never getting back together. And and Max looked at me and said, we have to write that. And we did. And as soon as I played it for anyone in my life that I trusted, they just kept singing it over and over again and got it stuck in their heads. And I'm really happy when I look out into a crowd of thousands of people singing the words back to me, knowing that it came from such a spontaneous and fun thing. The song Stay, Stay, Stay is a song that I wrote based on what I've seen of real relationships, where it's not perfect. There are moments where you're just so sick of that person and you get into a stupid fight and, you know, it's still worth it to stay in it, you know, because there's something about it that you can't live without. And it says, you know, in the bridge it says, I'd like to hang out with you for my whole life. And I think that's probably the key to finding the one, is if you just want to hang out with them forever. The Last Time is a song that I wrote with Gary Lightbody of Snow Patrol. I had always wanted to work with Snow Patrol. They're my favorite band. And this was a song that I wrote about something I had been going through, where you've got, I picture like a door, you know, and you've got on the outside of the door, standing outside in the cold, is this guy who's left his girlfriend over and over again and come back and asked for a second chance. Over and over and over again. And on the other side of the door, you have this girl standing there with tears in her eyes, wondering how she could possibly turn him away when she loves him this much, but she can't get hurt again. And it's both of these people swearing that this will be the last time. She's swearing it's the last time she's going to take him back. He swears it's the last time he's going to leave her and hurt her. So it's a really intense song, and I'm so proud to have Gary on the record. The song Holy Ground was a song that I wrote about the feeling I got after years had gone by and I finally appreciated a past relationship for what it was, rather than being bitter about what it didn't end up being. And I was sitting there thinking about it after I'd just seen him, and I was just like, you know what? That was good. It was good having that in my life. And I wrote the song, and I immediately heard Jeff Basker's production. I had never worked with Jeff, but he has done some amazing work. I love what he's done on Fun's record, and I love his diversity. He's just so talented. And so I called him, and I said, I wrote this song. I really want you to work on it with me. And I played it for him, and he was like, let's go. This is great. And he did such an amazing job on it. Sad, Beautiful, Tragic is a song that I wrote while I was on tour, and I was on a tour bus that was moving, and I just started playing this really haunting, sad chorus, and it just kind of was very simple, like, what a sad, beautiful, tragic love affair. And it was just reflecting on something that was lost, you know, and you can't get it back. And I went home and I called up Nathan Chapman and said, hey, I wrote a song, please, 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 can we record today? And of course he said yes, and we used that original demo on the album because it just kind of came across so pure and raw. The Lucky One is a song that I wrote while I was in Australia, and it kind of talks about some of my fears through telling the story of other people that I was inspired by. But, you know, more than their stories being told, I'm pretty much singing about what I'm scared of in that song, ending up kind of caught up in this whole thing and lonely and feeling misunderstood and feeling like when people think you're lucky that you're really not. So it kind of expresses my greatest fear of having this not end up be fun anymore, having it end up being a scary place. And some people get there. Some people end up there. So it's a story song, and it's something I'm really proud of because it kind of goes to a place that I'm terrified of. Everything Has Changed is a song that I wrote with Ed Sheeran, and He is such a talented person in so many ways. He's such an incredibly talented guitar player and singer and songwriter and performer. And writing this song with him was so much fun because, you know, we were sitting in my backyard writing this song, and he started singing harmony on it, and I asked him if he would record it with me as a duet, because it's about this moment that both people are having where they see each other and all of a sudden the world looks different because everything changed. Starlight is a song that I wrote actually after seeing a picture of Ethel and Bobby Kennedy when they were 17. I saw this picture about a year and a half ago, and I didn't know anything about like what they were doing or what was going on in the picture, but I just thought, they look like they're having the best night. And so I wrote this song about what the night might have been like. And I ended up meeting Ethel and going and playing it for her, and she just loved it. It was such a fun moment when she was just in love with the song and so happy about it. And it's just this adorable picture that to me just like brought forth all these potentials for how that night could have been. Begin Again is a song that I wrote about getting through a breakup and really being still kind of sad about it and feeling a little insecure about all the things that relationship made you feel were wrong with yourself. And after months and months and months, having the courage to stand back up and dust yourself off and go on that first date. And it's about kind of the vulnerability involved with that and the idea that you realize that, wow, this could be great, and maybe I don't have to be hurt anymore.